already know what it is. Think it's about that time. Welcome to the room, yo, take a seat. Grab a snack, kick back your feet. The stream is near, but now it's here. Time for the show, no need to fear. Welcome to the fan, feel free to chat. Coming in strong like a running back. There's only one rule, don't be a troll. The Rock gonna come and let you know your role. Mop going in, going all or nothing. Don't forget to hit the follow button. Mop's crew got all the swagger. Spamming the room with all the cappers. Taco Bell and Taco Supreme. Keep your eyes open for a secret stream. Hang a while, never overstayed. Every now and then mistakes are made. Look for entertainment, then look no more. Best recognized Mops in 64. Yeah.
Good evening, everybody. Guys, thanks for hanging out on today's modcast. My friends and I have a good topic to talk about today. Something that we've probably all experienced at some point in our streams. Let me get you guys to the cast. Welcome my mods. I got Ooze Dude, Nerdist the Cat, and Smithy Boy. Welcome to the modcast, guys.
Woohoo!
Everybody, why don't you guys all introduce yourselves? We'll start off by what I see and start you off. Let's start off with Smithy Boy. He's a first timer here. Why don't you tell us about yourself? Tell us where you're from and what games you like to stream.
Hey, everybody. I'm Smithy Boy. I am from Scotland, as you can tell, obviously, from my very strong accent. I'm right into the H1Z1 now. We need to win a Battle Royale soon.
Oh, definitely, definitely. Yeah, he's one of my first followers, actually. Next to him, you have Liz, a.k.a. Nerdist the Cat. Say what's up.
What's up, guys? I'm back for more.
Back for more. Tell us a little bit about yourself for the people that haven't seen you.
Chat mom of Mobster Stream and rule enforcer of the chat and minor fellow streamer. Very minor fellow streamer.
Very minor. And last but not least, our resident rapper, Oozed Dude. What's up, bro?
What up, everybody? How's everybody doing? I am the Ooze Dude, and I am the maker of the intro.
He is the one that spit out the lyrics for the intro. Guys, give him a kappa. And seems like to be a slow afternoon, but thanks, guys, for hanging out. What's up, Sensei? Tigers. Man, thanks for hanging out today, and today's topic is going to be an interesting one because we are going to be talking about trolls and how they can affect us or not affect us and how to deal with them. So, guys, what do you guys think? What's your experiences, each one of you guys, with a troll? And whoever wants to start.
So I think with the whole troll thing, it's just, I feel like it's people just reaching out for attention somehow. They find some sort of streamer. It's like, well, let's start some issues. Let's start some problems. Let's have some attention on me. That's great. So, but I mean, they come and go. It comes with the territory, I think, with not only Twitch, but YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, all of that. Hate is going to hate. So
exactly.
Hate is going to hate.
Hate. Don't hate the play, I hate the game, man. Come on.
Exactly. And did you ever want to share a story of what, you know, did you ever have a troll in your stream? I mean, I know it might be a little different for females. I don't know. They might respect you more. Us guys, they'll be assholes to us sometimes, you know. But for you, they'll be like, "Oh, I love your voice. You sound so good." Oh. You know, do you feel that? Do you feel that difference?
For me personally, if it's happened, I haven't noticed, or I just don't, I choose not to remember it. But I've heard of a lot of groups and people like seeking out female streamers just to kind of be like, show us your tits. Why do you suck? Fuck you in this game. Just show us your tits. And it's like, oh, God, I feel so bad for these people. So, but yeah, no, I just either I, it must have happened at some point, but I don't stream often enough to like actually remember something specific. but you know, maybe I should just be on it more. Maybe that'll teach me. So, but yeah, no, I haven't had any like personal issues that I know that I remember.
Okay. How about you guys?
I've had some, definitely had some trolls in my stream before. One of the last times I could recall was I just had somebody in my stream just whispering people. And the biggest problem was I couldn't see it happening. So I had no idea. You know what I mean? But that was one of the last times I've had a troll in my stream. They were just whispering some pretty bad stuff to people and kind of scaring people away from my stream, you know? And I had no control over it because, like I said, I didn't know it was happening. So kind of crappy.
Did that get you pretty bothered, or are you just pretty chill? You seem to be like a chill guy, so you know I don't see it affecting you in any way, you know?
Well, I definitely played it cool. I tried, you know, I didn't get so mad until I realized it was affecting my viewers, really. When it was chasing people away, that's kind of when it started to bother me. Like Liz said, it's people just trying to get attention, you know? Mm-hmm. People need some kind of attention. They need some kind of, I don't know, some kind of outlet to try to, I don't know what they're trying to do, but yeah, they're screwing around and it screws up the whole stream and it sucks. It definitely sucks.
Yeah, I totally agree with you when it messes up the whole atmosphere, the whole, you know, room. I mean, how about you, Ross? What's your experiences with trolls per se, or people that just like to bother you on your stream? I mean, actually today, I don't know if you noticed it, but yeah, I was, we were playing our Rocket League, right? And someone was in there saying like, oh man, you suck, blah, blah, blah. And he ended up playing with us, you know? You pretty much did nothing, and that troll was put in his place. So I don't know. What do you think about it?
Yeah, I've had a few trolls all the time, but I just brush them off.
Oh, yeah? You've
don't
never...
really bother me.
You've never had a point where it's like, oh man, this guy's really just bugging me. You're cool with that?
Yeah, fine. It doesn't bother me. You could say it no man. I don't mind. So they end up just fucking off anyway. So
yeah, that's true.
So win-win.
I mean, that's the thing with streaming. Yeah, you. I know you have to have a thick skull to do this stuff, because if you're sensitive and you get butt hurt every time someone just causes ruckus in your room, then yeah, this is not for you, but you got to expect it, you know? And I don't know, why do you guys think these people come into a room? I know a lot of us know pretty much the same answers to this question, but what do you think the main purpose of a troll is to come in a room and just, you know, bombard with stupid comments?
They're just getting nothing better today with our time, and they'll just want to fuck off everybody else's night.
True.
Yeah.
True, you know. I was reading from a research paper about trolls earlier that, of course, they want in for attention. And, I mean, you really, really have to, like, want that much attention to come into someone's stream and just either make fun of the streamer or everyone in the room. I mean, that's ridiculous, right?
So I think it's not only like I've been reading a couple articles, and a lot of times people say that it's just like for attention seeking. Sometimes people say that they come in just because they had a bad day and they're trying to shit on everybody else's day and be like fucking miserable. It's like, well, fuck you guys. I'm feeling really bad, so I'm going to make you guys feel just as bad as I do.
That's true.
So, yeah, you have to. Yeah, you have to kind of like empathize with them on some level. Like some writers have talked about that in terms of trolls, and it's like, well, you have to really empathize and put yourself in their shoes. Like, okay, well, why do you feel this bad? Why do you feel this way? Why do you feel like doing this into my chat? Like, yeah, what kind of person do you think, well, what would make you feel better about this situation type deal? So, mm-hmm. You know, I don't know.
I totally agree. Like, Sensei, you say research on trolls, but if people don't know how to handle trolls and you're going to be a streamer, consider yourself done. You have to have a certain level of, you just have to have a thick skull, basically. Tolerance. You need tolerance and stuff. And I've seen people break down on stream because someone was just being an ass or something. But that is true. You know, that is definitely true. But I mean, luckily for us, you know, it's never been that bad. Oh, actually, I could share earlier, like, you know, when I was kind of learning how to stream and stuff a couple months ago, you guys were actually on it. I was telling you about a certain person that came into the room. He started whispering to the other people in the room, and either he was trying to harass or flirt or whatnot, but this guy would not leave, you know, and it was bothering me. Like, we even had a thing about, okay, let's go report this to Twitch and take a screenshot of whatever and things like that. You know, what are we supposed to do with that kind of troll that just likes to keep harassing and stuff? I mean, I hope you guys never had to go deal with something like that where, I mean, Ooze, you did mention someone that was doing that in your stream, right? Someone was, what was he saying to the other people in chat?
Well, at the time, I talked about this one of the last modcasts too, but I was streaming Minecraft, so I was kind of getting a younger crowd.
Yeah.
And the guy was just saying he was going to, like, kill people, and, like, if you continue watching this person, he's going to show up to your house. And I had, like, 12, 13-year-olds, you know, in my stream at the time. And they got freaked out, and luckily one of them ended up messaging me,
yeah,
and they sent me screenshots on Instagram of what the person was saying. And I got the person blocked, but then they made another name, and they came back, and they did the same thing over again.
Oh,
and
God.
Yeah, it was a pain in the butt. But eventually the person stopped coming back.
Yeah.
And the only way I tried handling the situation was by just trying to, like, kill them with kindness in a way. So, like, if I feel like if you react more, they get a reaction out of you, they're going to keep it coming. Yeah. But if you're kind of just like, all right, listen, man, come on, like, please don't do this. Like, they're kind of just like, all right, you know what? This guy isn't a bad guy.
Mm-hmm.
You know? I don't know.
No, that's definitely true. I totally agree with that. Actually, in one of the papers I was reading, they said kill him with kindness because eventually they're going to run out of things to say. That's what they say. And if they are there for attention, but if you get riled up, you're going to give them more of that attention. So, yeah, I guess a lot of streamers do brush them off. But I actually read one where, okay, this guy was totally cool with trolls. He'll entertain trolls as long as, you know, whatever problems, things like that. That's a good thing that you mentioned that. Kill him with kindness, and it worked. Actually, I did that yesterday on a stream, and this guy ended up, like, being cool. He was making fun of my Manchester United jersey. Not you, Ross. Not you, by the way. It was someone else. Yeah, but he ended up being cool after. But Ross, problems, things like that. That's a good thing that you mentioned that. Kill him with kindness, and it worked. Actually, I did that yesterday on a stream, and this guy ended up, like, being cool. He was making fun of my Manchester United jersey. Not you, Ross. Not you, by the way. It was someone else. Yeah, but he ended up being cool after. But Ross, so how long have we been streaming? We've done this for how long ago? Has it been a year already?
It's been a year and a half, maybe.
Has it been a year and a half? I heard, like, aliens. I heard something weird, man. What was that?
Sorry, yes. Totally.
Are we being invaded as we speak? But, I mean, Ross, you seem like a super chill guy. I don't think you ever get mad. You know, whether you're sober or drunk, you seem to be, like, an awesome, happy-go-lucky guy. You've never had any experiences with anyone bothering you on your stream, even from the PS4 days?
No, the PS4 days were the good days. You never really got a lot of people. I never really got a lot of viewers or anything on that, but it was always good starting off on the PS4.
Yeah, that's true. Usually you get the viewers that are like, oh, you're on the PS4? Add me as a friend. Let's play together. No, first they'll say, oh, you suck. Add me as a friend. Let's play together. That, like, today. That's what happened today. But yeah,
yeah.
It's cool. Other than that, like, yeah, people that cause trouble on streams, like, yeah, in a way it does kind of cause a hurdle when you just want to have a stream and you're actually providing a service for people. You're trying to just entertain. You're basically entertaining people, trying to make them not think of the real stuff going on in life. You're just, you know, trying to give them an escape. But when people interrupt that setting, oh yeah, it's rough. And I don't know, man. Trolls just suck, dude. I mean,
just like the day they came in, he was saying I was shite, whatever. And I was like, I'm just here to play with my mates, have fun.
Yeah.
And then they stalk straight away. You don't need much to stalk them, just tell them straight away and that's it.
Exactly. So, and then, and Liz was even backing you up too. He's like, practice makes perfect and stuff. And I think a troll's weakness is kindness. It's like their kryptonite, man. It is like their kryptonite. And you know what? I think that's everyone here does a good job with that. For some people, I don't know how they're going to take it. I know some people in our crew, they're going to start streaming stuff. Let's see if they could take the harassment of others. Because some people could be sensitive and some people won't. Like, what else have you read about, Liz, from what you were seeing? Like,
like what you were talking about before, like the whole kill them with kindness, like something that Twitch offers online is like a Twitch 101 course.
They really have a
course? I don't know if it...
They really do?
Well, it's what the article is titled, Twitch 101. And I don't know if it's the same writer or if they pull from different streamers, but from this one streamer, Bro Tato. He was talking about how, one, the mods are your first defense for any streams. So if like somebody's like trying to stir the pot, you got the mods there. Like if you have a mod that you can trust and kind of like bounce ideas off of them, and like they're your like barrier for everything. Like they should know what you're thinking. They should know what you want like to happen. Like, oh, well, this person should probably just be timed out or whatever. This person's like really causing an issue. They should be aware of how you want to go through with it. Mm-hmm. Bertato was talking about how demeanor is key. He's like, if you exude this sort of, like I said before, empathic way of how to discuss with them, when he sees somebody, and he refers to them as undesirables. He doesn't even title them as trolls in his stream. He's like, I address them as a human. And I say, you know, when you're doing this, you're disrupting the community, and you're not just disrupting me. Like you're getting in the way of what's happening right now, and you're bringing it down. Like, I hope you're aware of that. You kind of have to just work around it sometimes. Like he'll encourage his chat to just kind of keep on doing what they're doing. Mm-hmm. But like what you were saying before with the one streamer who is like, I'll put the ban hammer on the guys that are screwing with my mods or my viewers, but like you can screw with me all you want. That's fine. Yeah. And that guy, what was it? It was from GameStreamingCentral.com. This guy, K-Dog, he's talking about like, I don't ban people unless they really call for it. Because sometimes if you're talking to the trollers, maybe you can kind of turn them around and get them as like a regular viewer, and you can build a positive relationship with them and stuff. But he's also a firm believer of the whole kill him with kindness ideal of it. It kind of depends on everybody's flow with how they do it. So
totally agree with
different
that.
Strokes. So
by the way, DJ Beat says, his mods are cool dudes and dudettes. You guys got props already from chat, man. They love you already, man. Thanks, DJ Beat. But I was going to say an example of, I remember one of the first times I was streaming. I remember I was doing the PS4, stream thing, Twitch thing. And I just remember I was doing like GTA or something. And then someone just came in the room and was like, fuck you, and left. I'm like, what?
Fuck you.
Yeah, and just took off, dude. So I was like, is this the way stream life's going to be? But you're right, kill him with kindness, right? And... it's a weird thing. It's kind of a trip, dude, because like when I tell people the story, they just start laughing at me, man. Kill with kindness kills trolls and makes friends. Exactly. You convert them. You assimilate them to be good people.
You can save them.
Yeah. Oh, I remember. When we were reading up on trolls and stuff, they also said trolls could be very valuable to the streamer. For one, they are another statistic, added to your viewership. So one guy even said that he rather would have a room full of trolls than have nobody watching at all. Because, before the trolls came in, they had no one watching the streams. Now that people are having trolls in the streams, there are viewers. But, it's going to be a jackass experience, but you have viewers. So what would you rather have? No viewers? Or just a bunch of assholes that are on your stream, right? So, in a way, you kind of use it to your advantage. Is that right? That's what the research showed, right?
So, yeah, like who you're talking about, that was still a K-Dog. He was like,
yeah,
you're really quoting K-Dog a lot. Yeah, no, he was like, you know what? It just kind of depends. I mean, you don't want to have nobody, but at the same time, if you have like a bunch of people just hating on you,
yeah,
you can't let that bother you. If they see that you're going to get a rise, then that's what keeps on happening. But there was actually this one site, Real Gamer. The writer for that site, he's like, well, we have this special Facebook group and it's a bunch of streamers, and every week we have a goal designated for that week. Like if it's get 25 new followers, if it's I don't know, whatever, they have like weekly goals set up, like get 5 new subs or something like that, stream like a whole game in 1 week. Mm-hmm. And if you have like goals, like end goals set up for yourself, it's like you have to come back the next week and say why you didn't do it. It's like, well, I only got 15 followers, not 25, because I was arguing with trolls the whole time. It's like,
exactly.
They're going to bring you down. They're like your mental blockade for it. If you guys are like looking to achieve bigger, better deals on Twitch or YouTube or wherever you're doing it, you can't let them be that little hurdle for yourself. So mm-hmm. I thought that was interesting when you kind of plugged that too.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think that's a good idea for us too, to have goals for us. But,
Yeah,
I think it's just it's like trolls only really have particular things to say. It's like, you suck, your product sucks, and I'm so much better than you. Why are you even streaming this? Exactly. So really, it's just, I mean, yeah, it's got to be the whole like water off duck thing, man. You can't, either you can choose to engage in it, or you can choose not to, or you can just have like your chat like gang up on them, be like, we have no time for you.
We need a chat gang. That's what we need.
Yeah.
Straight out of chat.
Sucks versus goals, yeah.
But the funny thing is, the repeat offender trolls seems to always come back to the stream. It's like they don't have no other channel to go check out. They want to hang out and troll on your same channel, which is funny. It's like, really, we suck so bad, you guys can't leave, you know? It's like, they just like to come back. It's all about attention.
They really love the stream.
Yeah, they really love the stream. For instance, yesterday we were streaming and there was this, it's sad that I call this guy the first harasser and stuff of my channel, but he was added as a follower here again, and he knew that he couldn't chat with me because I think in order to chat in our streams, you have to have a confirmed email, right? So he actually talked through someone else to tell me like, hey, tell Mark this is blah blah here. Tell him I'm sorry. he wanted to apologize through someone else. I'm like, you gotta be kidding me, right? That is just ridiculous. And you guys know what I'm talking about, right? So
yes.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
And they just come back. They just come back. Like, ooze, what, man, how do you think we can, is there any way to avoid trollship, I guess I'm going to call it trollship? What would you do?
I don't think there's any holding them back. If they're going to come, they're going to come. You know what I mean? But I like what you said before about how, in a way, they can almost benefit you. Because one thing about trolls is, if they are trolling, it's going to be some form of, I guess you could say, entertainment, like for people who are watching, because they want to see how you react to it. They want to see how people are reacting into a chat.
Yeah.
Also, they keep the chat alive too. Like sometimes, I'll stream for hours and there'll be like maybe like 15 comments I'm staring at the entire time that's not even moving. But if there's a troll in there and people start bagging on him or something, you know what I mean? The chat's going to be flying. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So at the same time, it almost helps. And then you kind of see who's loyal to your stream at the same time. You know what I mean?
Exactly. It's very interesting. Now that you put it in that perspective, I think this seems like an intervention to love trolls. I guess we're going to learn to love them and use it for our advantage. Hey guys, I want to welcome everyone to chat. There is going to be a part at the end of this the session where you guys could ask any of the mods anything, anything you like, anything with troll. You know, if we could stick to the subject and stuff. But it's just been a wild ride so far with the streaming crew. So, what do you think, Ross, from the days that we started to how we're streaming now? Do you think it's been a big change?
It's been a very big change because we used to stream on PS4.
Yeah.
Chat outside. Now we're all on the PC. Yeah. Streaming through the cameras.
See? So. And look, we've upgraded to PCs. And, you know, we spend a lot of money trying to do this. I guess it's more of a service for people. It's like, I didn't realize how much we spent. Look, you got yourself and Joey, Ooze Dude here. We all bought PCs, you know, and for the purpose of one of the purposes is to stream. Joey's going to be doing some video editing as well. But, yeah, look at how much we spent. And, you know, Liz hopefully sometime will get some PC or something. I hope, chat, you guys, don't deal with a big problem with trolls as we have. But we've spent money to entertain you guys. I hope you guys are enjoying this, you know. And, yeah, you know, it's the stuff we like to do. It's like, I don't know. I can't imagine being a troll just coming in and just starting up, like, you know, some shit or something. It's, like, stupid. It's totally. Sensei is a troll and they live under the bridge. That's great. Great, great, great.
Trolls just need a hug. That's all there is to it.
You know, that should trolls be someone's logo. Someone should have a logo.
That should be a shirt.
Yeah.
Trolls belong under a bridge. Yeah.
That is an awesome idea for a shirt, dude. That is a totally awesome idea. Man, I'm surprised there's not too many names with the use of troll.
Wait, isn't there a guy with troll in his
there's
name?
There's X-Troll Bubbles.
Oh, that's yeah. true. Yeah, that's right. He's one of our mods. Well, he was one of our mods. he hasn't been around lately. But yes, that is his name, Troll Bubbles. That sounds very intimidating. Yeah.
It's very, like, oxymoronish.
Troll Bubbles. Troll Bubbles Gaming. Troll Bubbles Gaming. But, man, I'd like to welcome our Scottish friend, man. He is a first timer on this, man. Is what we try to do weekly. We try to do Troll King.
Time difference is a bitch.
Yeah, you know, it's a. So, like, what do you look forward to your streaming, Ross, since you are now a regular streamer as well? Are you looking to grow your stream as well? Guys, you should follow this guy, by the way. It's Smitty Boy, Bahoy, 1888.
Smitty Boy.
Boy.
I just hope to get the channel up and running and just keep putting out good content, hopefully.
You know, I remember you did one stream that you streamed with Maxine, and I thought, oh, that's so cute. Oh, remember you guys had the couch, you had the whole setup, and like, I think your title was like teaching the lady or wifey to play GTA. Yeah, that's a great family game. Shorter.
Never went well.
Bust some caps, you know. Hey, well, and let's get on to Joey since his significant other popped in. Welcome, Joey. Kayla. Terror King Troll Chaos Captain. Is that a thing? It was a picture of a hand with like 1,000 holes in it. What's that?
Kayla's afraid of holes.
What?
it's like a mental, like, it's actually a condition to be afraid of holes, and she's one of the people in the
is
world
that, really?
That are afraid of holes.
Honestly? Really?
Yeah.
Hole phobia? Yeah. Is that what it is?
Butthole phobia? Yeah.
Well, holes, any kind of holes, from assholes to potholes to everything. I'm sorry
pot
for
holes.
You, dude. They should make a virtual reality game where you are fighting holes. You're just poking holes left, right, holes. I hope you find a way to combat hole syndrome. It's a serious cause. Very serious cause. Liz, what you doing over there?
I'm making adjustments.
Adjustments? Good. Guys, this is the pre-dinner stream. That is what we're eating. Simon looks tasty.
He's like, nope, I'm out.
This is the cat that likes to print stuff on your computer. He's a smart cat, by the way. Very smart cat. Tripopia? Is that Can we get a confirmation on that? Trypophobia. Huh. Interesting. We're going to have to look that up.
Quit Googling stuff.
Google that. Google that. Oh, Joey, where's your cat? I saw pre-stream. I saw a tail by you. I'm like, Joey does not have a tail. So I'm going to assume over your here. Cat.
She's chilling. She's on the Bowflex.
Oh, she's working out. She is a working out cat.
And, I think she might be sleeping. I don't know. Her head's just straight down. I don't know.
While she's flexing, you know. Meow. Meow. Meow.
Trypophobia. Sorry,
oh,
Caitlin.
No. She's going to freak out. She's going to freak out.
Meow. Hey, Ross, do you have any pets over here? Are you a pet guy? I don't seem...
No.
No, right?
No pets, man.
Okay, so I'm going to pitch something for your stream. You need to wear a kilt. You are Scottish. You need to wear a kilt for the stream. You know what? One of the themes should be like international, like modcast day, where you have to dress from your origin.
Oh, no.
So what are you? What are you, Liz? You are what? German? No.
I'm Irish, German, and Palestinian.
So which one would you represent?
I have the temper of
Palestinian.
Irish.
Palestinian, you want a sari? Is that what it is? The saris?
No, that's Indian.
Oh, no.
I can stream while drinking a Guinness. That can happen.
You, and Ross would have to drink one with you in a kilt.
No drink.
By the way, if you guys ever been on Discord, Ross does a great rendition, a Scottish rendition of Gangster's Paradise by Coolio. It's awesome. And I can't wait for Joey's YouTube channel. Guys, you guys gotta check out his YouTube channel. He will be making more vids. Hopefully he gets back to streaming at some point, Joey. At some point.
Hopefully. Hopefully.
Hopefully, hopefully. I know you've been pretty busy lately, huh?
Yeah, just stupid stuff here and there.
Oh, yeah?
Just holding me back a little. Mostly my Wi-Fi just kind of screwing up.
That's
the major
Wi-Fi.
Setback.
I think everybody has some issue with a Wi-Fi problem at some point in their streams and broadcasts and stuff. That's crazy, man. Dude, have we been on for a while? We haven't been on for a while, right? We still have time, guys. Time. Was there anything else you guys wanted to talk about besides, you know, I guess based on the subject of troll troubles? You know? I mean, we kind of handle that pretty well.
So there was one story I was reading that I felt so fucking bad for this kid. It was like a 13-year-old kid.
Yeah.
The author thinks that he might have been on some sort of autistic spectrum. So he had that going, and he was like slightly overweight. So this 13-year-old kid is streaming on Twitch, and these trolls come into the room, and they're pretending to be like Twitch service moderators or something.
Oh.
So they wind up talking this kid into, what was it? He like destroyed his mother's laptop. Like he deleted the hardcore, like the system 32 within the PC. So he deleted the essential part of making a lap or making a computer. So now it was essentially bricked.
Wow.
And they said, well, you have to work on, what is it, like de-electrifying the court. I don't know what they were telling this kid, but he wound up putting like some salt water mixture, like pouring that over the keyboard.
Yeah.
He put the laptop in the oven to like dry it up and stuff like that. And he took it out.
No way.
And he actually did this.
Yeah, and he was putting butter on the keyboard too. Like, they were telling him, like, to best have your laptop running or whatever, have it working, you have to do these things. So he put butter on it.
Did he say put some rice on it to get rid of the water?
And
like
he wound up taking out the battery, wrapping it in foil, and putting it in the microwave.
And how old was the kid
again?
Then,
like, 13. Like, this 13-year-old kid who was, like, not there.
Right,
like,
right,
he was
right.
just taking, like, what they told him as gospel. And it was just really, really sad to watch the video. It's like your heart goes out to this kid. And
oh,
then they have, yeah, there was a video in one of the articles. And it's like your heart goes out to this fucking kid because they wound up talking him into destroying his Xbox One too.
Mm-hmm.
So aww. It's like, oh, why are you guys? Why do you have to be like this?
Yeah.
It was
yeah.
just, It was such a bummer.
You know, people take advantage of that stuff. You know, I actually know of a mod that actually did that. They said there was some moderator from Twitch or something and did something to someone. But he was just messing around.
But, we don't know who that was.
Yeah, but that's what trolls do. I mean, they're there to start shit. And I hope if you guys have kids that want to get into the streaming business, please warn them of things like that, because it is a dangerous world out there. It is a dangerous universe. People will mess with you. People will get you to do crazy things. And, you know, people will do anything to get more followers or whatnot, but it's scary. But they gotta learn. They got to learn. Yeah, I think I also saw, you know, the ultimate troll is, I saw this video on YouTube where I guess it was a bunch of streamers that, I think it was either a prank or what, where some guy was streaming, but I guess one of his friends or neighbors or whatever actually called the cops to let this guy know that something was going on in the house. And yeah, they're playing Counter-Strike and stuff. You hear all these gunshots and stuff. They actually sent a SWAT team to this guy's house, broke down the door, and this happened in the middle of a stream. And they just busted the dude, and then until they found out what was going on. I forgot what it's called, but...
SWAT.
Yeah. Yeah. What was it called?
Swatted.
SWAT. Yeah. Yeah, dude. There was a lot of videos on that. I'm like, oh, God, that would just be the worst, dude. That would just be.
Yeah, that shit happens a lot, man.
It does, man. And I guess that's the risk we have to take doing this stuff. It's I don't know. It's a wild, wild world out there. But I don't know.
Say the least.
Swatting. What else did you learn from like the research you saw, Liz? I know you had like a lot there. I didn't get to see all of them, but
yeah, no, I only saw like a few things. But there was this one article that went into like super depth that I didn't really get into a whole lot when I was reading it. But there's this group called the Forzen Army or the Forzen Boys, which is like a notorious. I don't know if it's a 4chan thing or what, but they prey on female and minority streamers where they'll just bombard the streams and it's just
bad. Worse than like a raid? It's like worse than a raid or something?
It's worse than a raid, yeah. Like it's just this massive group of trolls that will just seek out a room and just pretty much destroy it the best that they can. It's just, yeah. Yeah, the Forzen Boys. Forzen Army.
So you really have to be on their like shitty side to be on their shit list.
Or just, you know, not be a white male. I imagine. Oh, wow.
Sorry, Joey.
So yeah, so, yeah. Joey and Ross are okay, but we're in trouble. Sorry, Ross.
Please don't rate our streams like that. We're good to you guys. We're good to you. Like,
450,000 strong or something, or maybe 45,000 strong. It was a really mind-bogglingly large number.
So for each one of you guys, I want you guys to give your little, you know, 2 cents on if for those up-and-coming streamers out there, what do you suggest for them to be better, whether it be on air or how to deal with shit or whatever. Each one of you guys got a little hint for everybody?
A lot of talking. Talk to the chat a lot. Just keep talking through the stream. It helps a lot.
Mm-hmm. Totally agree. Who else has one?
So I think, like, along with going, like, just let it roll off your back. You can also just play with it as you will, but just be yourself on a stream. You can't just let these guys just kind of totally take you down.
Yeah.
While you're doing what you really love doing. And if they take that away from you, then it's like, well, what else do you have? So got to go with the flow, man. Go with the flow.
Yeah, true, true. What about you, Joey?
I'd say just never take anything too seriously, no matter what anybody says. You know, you're doing what you like to do. And if somebody says something that gets to you, make like it's not getting to you, because then they're just going to keep going. So just try to kill them with kindness. And just keep doing you. Do what you like to do and just shake it off.
Yeah. Guys, welcome all the people that are coming into the stream right now. We just had our discussion on how to deal with trolls, why trolls do what they do, and how to combat it. So, there will be a point where you guys could ask any of the mods here anything you like. I guess. Someone already asked, how big was your water bottle as it pertains to trolls? Welcome. Welcome, people are coming in. But
I said it was 50 ounces. That's a lot of ounces.
That's a lot of water, man. Shit. That is a lot of water. Yeah. Earlier, you should have seen all what everyone was doing. Like, Ross was eating a pizza. Joey here had some Taco Bell. And Taco Bell. And Liz was just doing her thing, getting ready for the stream. Me,
Liz was being Liz.
Yeah, I think the next cast should be bring your pets to the stream day. Everyone could meet the cats and dogs and...
You know what that one's going to be called? It's going to be the Mod Cats.
I was just going to say that.
I mod see cat. What you did
the
there.
The Mod Cats.
I seen what you did there, guys. All right, guys. I'm going to open up the chat room to questions. If you would like to get a question answered by any of these guys, feel free to ask. And please make it a legit question. You know, something that we could logically answer, not some whack one. And welcome you guys that are back. But
to be fair, I think I would answer a whack question as well.
Same. Okay, Liz.
As long as it's whack and not wiggity whack, then that's just wiggity. Crossing a line.
No wiggity whack.
Dude, I want to have Joy do an awesome flow just live, just for a little bit, if you can. He is, by the way, he is the one that does the intro for the stream. If you guys are just straddling in right now, he is the voice behind the Pac-Man theme. So, I don't know, Joey, if you're down.
Oh, my freestyle game ain't there, man. It's not there. I'm trying to get back into it, though. I'm trying to. I really am. My freestyle used to be good, but it's got to be something you do every single day, like all the time, whenever you have free time. So you can, your brain needs to be there. You know what I mean?
Oh, we do have a legit question here. How do you get constant Twitch viewers that come back? Would you guys like to answer it?
You got to keep them entertained, keep talking to them, try to almost get on, not too personal, but a personal level with them, you know, definitely ask them their name, where they're from, what games they like to play. I feel like people are really into that. You know, they like to feel like they're at home when they're watching you and they want to interact with you. I feel like that's a good way to keep people coming back and to keep talking. And I think that's the good way to do it.
Yeah, definitely.
Put in a lot of hours.
Liz, you're on mute, muted. By the way. Liz, you're muted.
Oh, no, there I am. Sorry, I had to cough a lot and then it went away. But yeah, no, Joey's right. Like, totally engaging with the streamers, and because why else are you broadcasting it? Like, you're there to have people come and chat and hang out with you and stuff like that. So yeah, definitely engaging. It's awesome.
And Ross, go ahead. Oh, go ahead. Sorry, I cut you off, Liz.
But yeah, it's engage with them. And if you're okay with talking to yourself, because sometimes, if you're brand new to streaming, nobody's going to be in your chat for, a very long time. But if you're okay with talking about nothing to yourself, then, yeah, people will be like, hey, what's this guy talking about? Oh, okay, I played that game, too. Well, let's communicate with each other. Yeah. So, yeah, it's just, yeah, be okay with talking to yourself for hours on end and engage with the people that want to engage with you on a positive note.
Exactly.
And be you too. Don't try to be like anybody else. Be you. Be natural. You know what I mean? If you try to be like other streamers, it's just not going to work. You got to just have your own thing going on. Do you. It's going to be more natural. More people are going to want to come back and talk to you. And if you're being like somebody else and eventually you stop being like that person, people are going to be like, yo, what the fuck happened to this guy? Why isn't he doing this anymore? Just be you and people will keep coming back.
Exactly. And Ross, you were saying something. What were you going to say?
I just put a lot of hours in, have a good schedule. Because if you're streaming near enough every day, you've got a schedule. You still know when you're streaming, you can come back.
That's important, schedules, because, you know, people are going to, if they like your stuff, how are they going to know when you're going to go on? They can't just be going by that notification or email every time, you know? So how long have I been bald for? Oh, well, long time.
He bald long time.
We're going to have a bald stream next. Oh, no, modcast. You guys have to shave your head or wear something that makes you look bald for the next one.
We're a bald cap. We'll all get some bald caps.
That would be awesome. When did your mod start streaming? When did they start streaming, and what game was it that they played? Anyone care to answer that?
Yeah, my first game on a stream. Mm-hmm. Ooh, it was in a PS4 anyway. I think it was
GTA?
Batman.
Was it Batman? Is that Arkham Knight? Is that the one you had?
Aye. No, yeah. It could have been then. Must have been something else.
How about it had to be that or GTA. It's one of those, right? How about you guys?
GTA. I started streaming because you made me start streaming. Yeah. Actually,
you make it sound like it's by force, dude. It's like, you better stream, damn it, Nerdist the cat.
That's exactly what happened.
Nerdist the cat. You better stream.
I think it was April of last year that I started streaming, and I'm pretty sure it was Assassin's Creed Unity or Black Flag. It was one of those two. It's probably Unity. It's probably that. I'm going to go with that. Mm. So.
Okay, so that was last April, huh? Mm-hmm. And Joey, what about you, dude?
I'd say probably close to a year ago now. Probably about a year, I would say. Uh-huh. And I first started streaming GTA 5.
Oh, yeah?
That was my shit for a while, man. I was playing that game like crazy.
Dude, everyone loves GTA, dude. That's an awesome
game. Oh, man. It was so good. And I had a solid crew, like, running around with, too. So it was even better. I was rolling squad deep, screwing around with people.
Oh, you did that GTA Online stuff, huh?
Oh, yeah, dude. Oh, my God. I probably put, like, 500 hours into that game, no lie. Like, crazy amount of hours.
That's awesome, dude. It's awesome. Let's see. Who could do the most push-ups out of all of us?
Definitely not me. Definitely not me.
I could probably do like 30.
I could hang. I work out a lot. I could probably do. I used to do Insanity. If you guys ever done Insanity, that thing's crazy, dude. They make you do it. Sean T yells at you a lot in that vid. How about you, Ross? Are you a workout guy?
Nope. I go football. I do football.
Oh, yeah, football.
Soccer.
Liverpool. He is a Liverpool fan. Anyone here play RuneScape? That's old school, by the way. That's RuneScape.
I did like 10 years ago.
Yeah.
I didn't know what that was.
Favorite game? How about you guys? Favorite game?
Right now?
Yeah.
H1Z1.
H1Z1. You got 3 H1Z1s, and what's yours, Liz?
That's not fair. I can't play H1Z1. I'd probably say either Rocket League or Sleeping Dogs at the moment.
It says, how do you beat Brock in Pokemon The Blue?
I never played that one.
We do have a Pokemon expert. All right. So say your Team Rocket phrase and go ahead and answer the question.
Wait, who? Me?
Yeah.
Oh, I said I never played that one.
Oh, I thought you did. My bad.
No.
My bad.
I was like, what?
Let's see. Favorite sports video game?
Does Rocket League count?
That counts.
That counts.
That one.
Yeah.
Rocket League guy.
I like 2K.
He's a 2K guy.
NBA.
I like the UFC games. The old ones, actually. Can you run faster than the others because you are... Yes, my head was meant to be aerodynamic. And my
Usain
eyes
Bolt.
And my eyes are slanted too, so that adds more aerodynamic physics to my running stuff, whatever.
Let's see, Scruff11 asked, first game you guys ever played. Is that like ever in life, or like...
Oh, geez.
Is that like a throwback question? Mine would obviously be Donkey Kong on the SNES.
Wait, Donkey Kong Country, right?
Donkey Kong Country, yeah.
Uh-huh. What about you guys?
First game ever?
Ever.
Ever.
Alex the Kid.
Oh, wait. Alex Kid?
Alex the Kid.
Is that like Sega?
It was, you didn't need a cartridge. It was already built into the computer. When you turned to own, it came up. What was it, Mega Drive?
Yeah, that's the Sega Mega Drive. That's it. Yeah. That's right. Alex Kidd. That's right. I remember that.
Wee guy, and it was platform game. It was brilliant.
Oh man. How about you, Joseph?
The only thing that comes to mind is like Tony Hawk Pro Skater.
Oh my god! Yeah.
And like maybe Ocarina of Time.
Nice.
Yeah.
Man, I started with an Atari 2600, but my dad used to take me down to this pizza joint back in the day when I was like 3 or 4 years old. Oh, he was when arcades were still valid. I used to play a lot of Pac-Man and Donkey Kong in the arcades when you actually had to put quarters in. And arcades actually cost 25 cents. A quarter. Oof. Oh, my God. I miss those days. Then we bought an Atari 2600. And to my surprise, the Pac-Man on there was nothing like the arcades. It was very blocky. But it was the thing at that time. And then it grew from that to the NES to the SNES to what else? 64, you know, PlayStation started coming in. Let's see.
One thing I remember about the Atari is the, like, the whatever you want to call it, the handle. Like, I don't know if it was like automatically like this or if it was just over time got like this, but the, like, this thing was so stiff. Like, the handle itself, like, I could never, like, is that how it was from the beginning or is that like,
that,
like, it was like you could barely even move it. Like, I wasn't sure if it was just sitting in my attic forever and you couldn't move it. You know what I mean?
Believe me, that stick was very stiff.
I'm sitting there like, yeah, you know, that's that stick that was like real
stiff. The joystick.
Stiff.
Joystick?
Yeah, the joystick. Yeah. That's what I meant. Yeah.
It was just one stick. It was one
and
stick
button.
And, you know, you would just play.
And a red button, right?
You just play and press the button. You would press the button like that.
yeah that, Atari, we're talking about Atari.
This is what brought joy to many people back in the day, a stick.
The joy
that gives you joy stick. The joy stick. And besides that, they had this thing called paddles where it was like a knob. It's like a knob. This is not helping my cause, people. This is not helping my cause. But yeah, they had paddles where you could play games like Video Olympics, or you could actually play like Centipede and things like that. Yeah, it was things like that, dude. What else do we got? Yeah, Donkey Kong in arcades. Yes, Donkey Kong was in arcades at one point in our lives.
What's your favorite game to stream?
Right now?
It's Sensei.
It would probably be H1Z1. Pong. Is it? That's the one they use the paddles for. Exactly. Pong. But yeah, I'm H1Z1 for now. How about you guys?
Probably Rocket League for me.
Rocket League and all that.
Rocket League.
Yeah. Rocket League is fun to stream when you have other people in the game with you.
Remember, no one... Like, now it's great that it's all for all platforms and consoles and stuff. But I remember when it was only for the PS4 and it was free and everyone's like, what's this, soccer and remote control cars, blah, blah, blah. But it gets addicting. Like, it gets addicting, dude, definitely. Did anyone ever play the Doritos Crash Course on Xbox 360?
Nah. Is that like a Burger King game that you got in a Happy Meal?
A Burger King game that you got in a Happy Meal? That's like cross-contamination.
I mixed it up. Mighty Kids Meal, is that what it is?
I think it would just get me hungry. And I'm like, you forget this game. I'm going to eat a Whopper or a Big Mac or something.
I actually remember when me and Kayla first started talking that we always... Well, we were in high school, so we didn't have much money. And we wanted to buy video games. So we would go to like the Xbox 360 section of GameStop.
Yeah.
And there was like really cheap games there. And one of the games was like... Sneaky King or something, and it was a Burger King game. That's why I'm balls about it, because like we were like, it was like $1, we got it for $1, and we were playing it, we're like, man, this game sucks. Like, we were so pumped to go home and play it, and it was just a real shitty game. And I remember like a couple weeks later, I'm like, yo, you ever play that like Sneaky King game again? She's like, oh, I beat it. Like, she like beat the game.
Kayla,
like, I didn't even know she was still playing it.
Kayla must have like practiced every night and day. If CSGO,
we used to play zombies like crazy.
Ooh, if CSGO had a free-for-all, who would win out of all of you? You know what?
Ross.
We all do
I say Ross. I Ross. Say Ross would easily.
No,
Dude, we all have. We never played all together CSGO. We all have it, I'm assuming, right?
I don't. Yeah. I don't have it.
I thought you were going to get it, dude.
I was going to, but I just haven't yet.
You bought crates instead.
I know, we got to do that.
I bought Sneak King instead.
We got to do that one day, dude. Oh, but Joey probably got some Burger King games for Christmas, though. You got Burger King
Psych?
Games
for Christmas? Hell no.
Oh, I don't know who would win that battle, but yeah, CSGO, we were doing that for a while. It gets addicting after a while. Actually, Nerdist the Cat here loved CSGO at some point.
I was playing it for quite a bit for once, and then I got Black Ops, and then I moved my Xbox into my room, and then it was just all downhill from there.
Ooh, looks yeah. What about this? What's all your biggest fears? That's a good
oh god.
Question. Failure. No, I don't know.
Mine's is how do I say that on stream?
Yours is not having an answer to a question. Oh my god. No, I don't know.
So I'm afraid of the dark. Really bad.
Are you serious?
Really bad, yeah. And I'm afraid of drowning.
Oh.
And what? I'm afraid of heights. I'm afraid of heights too, like real bad. So like water parks are not good for me. I went to a water park and it was a tube that was pitch black in the water and it was really high. I'm gonna die. That's what's gonna happen. I'm gonna be dead when I get to the bottom.
Maybe you're scared.
I'm gonna be a limp body coming out of the bottom of the slide and in like shallow water. This happened recently. That's why I'm saying this. My girlfriend, my brother, and his girlfriend went to a water park, and they're like, "Come on, let's go on here." I'm like, "No, I'll just wave to you guys from the bottom, and I'll wait." So yeah.
Well, what about your fears?
Drowning.
Liz.
I have small, non-tangible.
Whoa!
And explain what your profession is again.
I'm an animal control officer. I'm an animal cop.
Animal cop, and she's scared of the animals. That's great. That's
I perfect. Face my fears every day at work. Rattlesnake calls are the worst calls. My God.
That's like Joey being a lifeguard. Someone gets stuck in the tube. What are you gonna?
And because they always whenever they're like in a room, they always like fly onto my head, and I freak out like horrifically. It's like, why are you on my head? Why?
You know,
and then I think they're gonna peck out my brain. I don't know. It's my unrealistic fear.
And explain what your profession is again.
I'm an animal control officer. I'm an animal cop.
Animal cop, and she's scared of the animals. That's great. That's
I perfect. Face my fears every day at work. Rattlesnake calls are the worst calls. My God.
That's like Joey being a lifeguard. Someone gets stuck in the tube. What are you going to do?
they're going to die. Sorry. So.
Pretty much.
what was yours again, Ross? Didn't you say you were still thinking about it?
Drowning.
I'm still waiting for that kilt stream, by the way.
I'm going to be wearing a kilt soon. My mate's getting married. So I might. Okay.
So when you rent it or whatever, you have to have a stream with it on. You have to. That's a must. That is a for sure must.
That'll get all the subs.
Yeah. Maybe all the lady subs. Guys, we're probably going to take one more. If you met one celebrity or athlete, who would it be?
Benedict Cumberbatch. Done.
Oh, my God. Benedict Cumberbatch. And why is that? Do you think he's just he's your kind of guy?
Because we can talk about Sherlock Holmes and Hamlet and Shakespeare together, and the way that he says Elizabeth is just very pleasant to my ear holes. So, yes.
How about you guys?
For me, I actually was just thinking about this the other day. I would do anything in my power to meet Jim Carrey.
Yeah?
I love Jim Carrey, especially nowadays.
Anything.
But no, I really like Jim Carrey. I like all of his positive speeches that he does now. And I saw recently Jerry Seinfeld's doing a new show. It's like comedians in cars with coffee or something.
Oh, yeah, drinking coffee and
with comedians.
In cars.
Yeah. And Jim Carrey was on the show, and it was like one of the coolest things I ever watched. Jim Carrey brought him back to this like. huge warehouse that he owns where he does these like paintings and stuff, and they're like really, really good. And everything about Jim Carrey, I just think he's a really cool guy.
Nice, nice.
He's who I'd want to meet.
Right on. How about you, Ross?
Henrik Larsson.
Yeah? Why is that?
He plays for Celtic Football Club, as you know, for Scotland.
Is he like your main star right now for your football team?
Oh no, he's retired. He retired a couple of years ago.
Oh, man.
He's Swedish.
Right on, man. I really don't know who I'd want to meet myself. I don't
John
know.
Cena.
John Cena. Actually, yeah, I did meet a couple wrestlers here and there, and you guys probably met them too. I know a lot of our fan base are WWE fans, in which Raw is coming to LA next week, so I think I'll be doing that. Oh, we got one. Actually, Ortizo has one more. Would all of you guys face me in a 5-on-1 CSGO handicap match if that would happen? You know what? There's this other guy named Eddie that we play against, and he rocks this all the time. He actually works for Kevin Pereira, if you guys know who that is, from G4. He's like an intern there. He whooped our ass like bad. So I wouldn't be surprised if you whooped ours pretty bad. It would be, we know you're probably good. I'm pretty sure you will rock us, dude. But, that's about it. It's been an hour and 10 minutes. Good modcast, guys. Thanks for being on. By the way, each of you guys, go ahead, plug in your stuff. Where could they find you guys?
Nerdist the Cat, Instagram, Twitter, and now Tumblr, apparently, at Nerdist the Cat.
Awesome. Awesome.
The Ooze Dude at Twitter and Instagram. The Ooze Dude.
The Ooze Dude. Okay. Gotcha there. And yep. Ross, go ahead.
Smuffy Boy and Twitter.
Mm-hmm. Right on. Okay, man. Hey, I want to thank everyone that was on the modcast today. It was awesome. Good times here. If you guys have any other subjects for us to talk about, or maybe you want to be on one of these things, hit me up on Twitter, the Instagrams, the Facebooks. You guys all know that. Guys, thanks a lot for hanging out this afternoon. Thank you, mods. Thank you, Joey, Liz, and Ross. I'm going to go ahead cut this out for now. You guys go ahead, stand by. And you guys are good. All right. Thanks, everyone, for hanging out. We will see you guys next week. Peace out.